campus of Princeton University, where President Johnson, in cap and gown, walks in procession at dedication ceremonies for the new Woodrow Wilson School of Public and International Affairs. The president is awarded an honorary Doctor of Laws degree, and during his dedication address, the chief executive takes the opportunity to make a firm reply to criticism of his administration's Vietnamese policy.
The exercise of power in this century has meant for all of us in the United States not arrogance, but agony. We have used our power not willingly and recklessly ever, but always reluctantly and with restraint. Surely it is not a paranoid vision of America's place in the world to recognize that freedom is still indivisible, still has adversaries whose challenge must be answered. Today, of course, as we meet here, that challenge is sternest at the moment in Southeast Asia. Yet there, as elsewhere, our great power is also tempered by a great restraint. What nation has announced such limited objectives or such willingness to remove its military presence once those objectives are secured and achieved? What nation has spent the lives of its sons and vast sums of its fortune to provide the people of a small, thriving country the chance to elect a course that we might not ourselves choose?
The president's plea to scholars for policy support is applauded by both faculty and students.